Good morning, Mr. Andrew.
Hello, everyone. It's nice to have you back. And in today's episode, you're in for a treat.
Woo!
I'm going to be talking about something that every municipality across Canada can implement in order to save their small businesses and create community resiliency.
Yeah!
This is a plan that's tried and tested and completely legal. We'll get into that. I just want to say to my community, the Riding of Essex, which encompasses Kingsville, Amherstburg, LaSalle, Lakeshore, Essex County, even the neighbors, okay, Tecumseh and Leamington, please pay attention because you guys are close, but you're not there yet. And what we can implement is going to absolutely save our economy, get everybody working, and create a more resilient region. So let's do that by playing a game. Let's start by playing a game. Okay, I want you to guess what's in my hand.
Money!
Yeah. And does everyone know what this is?
Money!
Yeah. But do you recognize these birds?
No!
No!
No. Do you recognize this lady?
Yeah!
Yes. And do you know what this is?
No! No!
This is one of my most prized possessions. This is a $25 note issued by CalgaryDollars.ca in the Arusha Center in Calgary. And this organization has completely saved the Calgary economy by having a more resilient community based around actual complementary currency, by having two currencies in their municipality circulating in the community. This is the topic of conversation for today, and so let's jump right into it.
Woo-hoo! Imagine you were able to easily support your Calgary community while you make money. Calgary Dollars allows you to show your loyalty to local businesses and exchange goods and services with other Calgarians. Plus, you earn rewards when you use it. You can feel good knowing that it's easy to buy and sell in full or partial Calgary Dollars. You'll be helping the economy, the environment, and the community.
Let me explain the limitations of Canadian dollars first, because that's crucial to understand. When you only have Canadian dollars in your pocket, every purchase you have to weigh against your opportunity cost. Like for kids, you know, you have to think about, should I buy this new bike or should I put the money in a savings account? Good question. For a grandparent, should I buy a new dishwasher or should I put the money into my retirement account? And, you know, to pay my bills coming up. Pay my medicines and pharmacy stuff. Good question. For regular people, every purchase is, you know, should I go and get my nails done? Should I go shop at this store? Should I pay for a babysitter? Should I do all these things? You have to weigh that against, oh, geez, I have to save my money to pay my phone bill, my gas bill, my electric bill, my insurance. This laundry list of expenses that we have every month, right? And so what I've come to find is that when you have more than one currency in your wallet, you're more apt to be able to spend money on purchases without feeling the dread of spending it on something else. Let me get the money and show you. All right, so we're going on a field trip. We're gonna go to Northern Ontario along the side of the highway and buy a burger from Weber's Burgers. Great. They only accept Canadian dollars, so I better only get a couple of burgers for us because I gotta pay for gas too and everything else once we get to the spot we're going. Great. We're going on a field trip. What we gonna buy? Let's go to Kingsville and do their open streets party.
Yeah!
And, they've got the community Kingsville dollars there, so we'll switch some out and get some Kingsville money. Now we're in Kingsville, and what are we gonna buy? Oh well, we've got all this Kingsville dollars. Let's spend it. Let's buy some burgers. Let's buy some drinks. Let's get some souvenirs. I see Our Farm Organics. Okay, let's get some fruits and veggies. Yes, let's get a lot of things because we have the Kingsville dollars. And it only comes around a certain time of the year. So now that we have them, we better spend them. Okay. We're going on a field trip. What we gonna buy? Let's go to Calgary, okay? Let's go to Calgary and hook up with their community currency and see what we can buy. They put on different market events, and the vendors come and participate, and they take 100% Calgary dollars, or they'll take 50% Calgary dollars, or they'll take 75% Calgary dollars. And this money circulates all year round. And if I go and spend it at the pizza place in Calgary and go get two pizzas, a pitcher of beer, some wings, I can pay whatever percentage they accept, and half in Calgary dollars, half in Canadian dollars, all year round. Now that restaurant is going to then turn around and pay some of its employees in Calgary dollars, or they're going to buy supplies with Calgary dollars, or when their air conditioner breaks down, they're going to pay 25% or 30% to the air conditioner repairman who just so happens to take Calgary dollars so that he can turn around and pay for the babysitter. Or he can turn around and go eat at a restaurant and spend 50% Calgary dollars, 50% Canadian dollars. This is how money should operate. You have to circulate it in the community. Money does not work when it's sitting in your savings account or your retirement account or your mutual funds and RSPs. That money is dead money. It's not helping anybody in the community. When you can circulate it, when you keep your money moving, that's when commerce happens. That's when small businesses can do a little thing and have a side hustle and, you know, make enough so that you can pay for one of those phone bills, electric bills, gas bills, rent, groceries, you know. This encourages economy, and especially encourages economy in the small businesses, okay? This is the main difference between having a community currency and having just Canadian dollars, is that who's going to participate in this? Home Hardware will participate in this. Is Lowe's or Home Depot? No. Who's going to participate in this? It's going to be Billy's. It's going to be Branko's. It's going to be Birdie's Perch. Who's going to participate in this? McDonald's, Burger King, Taco Bell. Okay? This is how you give small businesses and independent businesses a leg up over corporations. This is how you keep the money circulating in your community so that everybody has a chance to make a sale. This is how you incentivize people to go out and splurge a little bit and live a little bit and meet somebody and have an engaging purchasing discussion and all that stuff. So much resiliency is derived from just changing your money, right? I think that's their slogan. Change your money, change the world. And it's a completely legal thing. You see, Canada has one accepted legal tender, the Canadian dollar, but this is a completely legitimate legal thing with the CRA, is to have complementary currencies so that you have this and it's based off the value of that and you pay taxes on this and you account for it the same way it's that, but you're allowed so many more things and you can give grants to students and you can encourage people to set up new businesses and be entrepreneurial. This is what we need to do. This will secure our future and keep things local. This is the best tool local has. So let's do it. Let's get on it. Essex, Kingsville, Leamington, Tecumseh, everybody else who's using this system, let's move to this system. Let's do it year round. Have some sort of transfer system where I can trade my Essex for Kingsville. Why not? Let me trade my Leamington for some Amherstburg, eh? And so this is the assignment I want to give to everybody watching, okay? Pull out your pencil and notepad, because here's your assignment for the day. I want you to draw your money. What would your community dollars look like? What denomination would you use? Would you use a 25, or would you stick to regular stuff? You know, so get your notebook out, come up with your own denomination, and not only that, but your synonym for dollars, okay? So are you going to be Essex dollars or Essex bucks or Essex money? It's your decision. And so just like Calgary was able to put, you know, some nice friendly Canadian fishermen in a boat on the Bow River, you should draw a picture of what your money would be. Is it going to be birds like Canada used to have? Is it going to be prime ministers of the past? Is it going to be the different things I grow in the garden? I don't know. If it was up to me, I would say, I want to create an Essex Bucks program through the Essex BIA, and my pictures are going to be of bucks, of male deer, and the deer that we no longer have in our community because, you know, progress. So that's my presentation. Share it if you care, and let's do this, okay? This is a program that is super implementable, and it will create such a huge difference to everybody. Every small business can use this and benefit. So if there's anybody out there watching from the municipalities, anywhere in Canada, right? Municipalities or BIAs or charities, you can look into this program by going to calgarydollars.ca. And Melissa and her team have put together a 41-page marketing plan that answers all. It's like a question and answer guide. It's a marketing plan. It shows you how your organization can delve into this and create more resiliency and create more connections in the community. Keep your dollars flowing. Change your money. Change the world.